All right, Shalawan, Shalawan, Shalawan. I want to give all praises to Yahweh, Yahweh Shah, man. I'll be kind of slacking on this one, beloved ones. But I'm going to bring out a smooth precept, man, because I thought about this earlier, like an hour ago. And this scripture that I remembered, it proves that Jake, even the beloved Abraham and our forefathers and foremothers, man, they have very deep feelings for their spouses, man. All right. Man, I'm gonna prove it, because you got a lot of guys and women in the truth. Y'all are weirdos, and y'all don't seem to understand exercise common sense. But I'm gonna bring out Genesis 21 for you beloveds. Some of y'all might be married or whatever, but don't ever let a Jake tell you that you're emotional, okay? Even for you sisters, that you're emotional or that you're going off, you're sinning and all this other Pharisee bullshit, okay? Just because you cry or have feelings over a woman or a man. Not pop culture, but Genesis 21 and 9. And Sarah saw the son of Hagar, or Hagar, the Egyptian, right? So Hagar actually wasn't even a Ishmaelite. That was a damn Hamite. But stupid ass game, bro. Oh. Which she had born unto Abraham, mocking, right? Wherefore she said unto Abraham, cast out this bondwoman and her son, for the son of this bondwoman should not be here with my son, even with Isaac. Alright, so that's where the promise went through. But Sarah was like Hagar's son not finna rule with Isaac. He's not finna be the chosen. And the thing was very grievous in Abraham's sight because of his son. So you have a lot of 99% of you, Jake, y'all stop right there. See, he was only grievous because of the son. What you talking about? But yeah, to be grievous, displeasing, to be sad, right? To break, to shatter, to be broken. I mean, you broke my heart, man. You can't have feelings. You in the world to hurt, displease, ill, to afflict, man. Right? To punish, to vex. So that vexed, physically, socially, or morally, good for nothing, by breaking to pieces, man, to spoil. So it broke Abraham into pieces, man. And Yahweh said unto Abraham, and God said unto Abraham, wait, I think this word is Elohim. Yep, Elohim, bro. See? And the Elohim said unto Abraham, let it not be grievous in thy sight because of the lad and because of thy bondwoman. So it wasn't just because of the son, man. Abraham had deep feelings for Hagar, man. I'm pretty sure most of you Jakes that have a virtuous marriage, you're not thinking about leaving your wife or your husband, okay, or your wives. And that's how I know a lot of you Israelites, you don't know what love is. Y'all are dirty spirited people. I don't care about white girls. I don't care about none of this extra stuff. I don't care about none of this stuff, bro. It's time to move forward. But Abraham, the angel said to Abraham, man, don't let it be grievous. And because of thy son, because of his woman. In all that Sarah hath said unto thee, hearken unto her voice, for in Isaac shall thy seed be called. So Abraham didn't want to put her away. So I'm saying, I'm pretty sure he didn't really want to forsake his father, but he had to because his father was into idolatry. And Yahweh Shai said, if you forsake, you know, things on the earth, if anybody forsook mothers, houses, wives, whatever, ye shall receive a hundredfold. Right? And Abraham rose up early in the morning and took bread and a bottle of water and gave it unto Hagar, putting it on her shoulder and the child, and sent her away. And she departed and wandered in the wilderness of Beersheba. And the water was spent in the bottle, and she cast the child under one of the shrubs. And she went and sat her down over against him a good way off. So he was very far away, as it were a bow shot. For she said, let me not see the death of the child. And she sat over against him and lifted up her voice and wept. Now she emotional because she crying. And the Elohim heard the voice of the lad, and the angel of God, the Elohim, which is really Yahweh, through Yahweh Shai, that goes right over your people's head, called to Hagar out of heaven. Nah, that's volcanoes. It says out of heaven, and said unto her, what aileth thee, Hagar? What vexes thee? What makes you sad? Fear not, for God hath heard the voice of the lad where he is. Arise, lift up the lad and hold him in thine hand, for I will make him a great nation. See that? So the point of me bringing out this one was to show you Jakes, man. Beloveds have feelings for their spouses, man. Okay. So for you brothers, even for some of you sisters, man, if you have a righteous love connection that's pure and it's very, very deep and sentimental, don't let none of these elders or outsiders convince you that you're going off because you have feelings or you're crying over your wife or something. Like you Jakes are weird, man. You have no salt, man. Okay, and that doesn't mean that brother or sister is not focused on salvation. Y'all need to stop being one-dimensional, man. But again, it was grievous to Abraham to do that, bro. He didn't want to do that. So I just thought that was interesting, man. But it's midnight, so-called, and I'm finna lay it down, beloved ones. But peace and blessings and shalom.